directly. Now, another candidate who also scored some high points, surprisingly, yesterday, Bangon Pilipinas Vice Presidential Bet Perfecto Yasay.
Kung sakali po at dumating ang El Niño'ng katulad ng nakaraan na yan, ano po ba ang solusyon niyong magagawa?
El Niño man o wala, ang nagiging problema ng ating magsasaka ay hindi sa pagtanim. They know how to plant rice. They have the knowledge. Konting suporta lang ng gobyerno niyan, they'll be able to address problems of planting. Ang problema ay yung pagbebenta. Doon, dahil mayroon tayong middlemen. Ang mga middlemen, ang siyang kumikita ng gusto, hindi yung magsasaka. Tanggalin natin ng middlemen.
All right, Edna Co, I personally thought that he was winging that answer, but apparently the audience didn't think so. He got one of his highest scores for that answer. Again, you were saying that some of them were kind of taking from what Jay Sonza said. Do you think that Junior Yasay did a good job, if he did, of sort of pirating some of the ideas of Jay Sonza?
Well, I thought, well, probably it's, the reality is that probably Mr. Yasay really shared the idea of Jay Sonza on the issue there of agriculture, but I thought Mr. Yasay did very well as well in that. And he looked very sincere. He was answering from, you know, from really from his heart. And I thought he did well there. And that's why he deserved to have, you know, to have gotten high mark in that in that point.
Mm-hmm. Let me ask the two of you then. We saw the text results, the poll results. 54 Rojas, Binay 13, Fernando 13, Yasay 11, Ligarda 4, Sonza 4. Did that surprise any of the two of you?
No, as in boxing, I had the same score actually.
So does this say we shouldn't belittle those who are lagging in the surveys? I mean, some of them outperformed, for instance, Lauren, who's number two in the survey.
Yes, Cez, I agree with you absolutely that we should not belittle other candidates who have been scoring very lowly, very poorly in the survey. This, I think that Harapan was one great moment for Jay Sonza that was also great for Mr. Yasay. And
Jejo Barbina as well.
Jejo Binay did well, although I would share a similar rating, but I thought that the guys who got lower score could have gotten even higher. I mean, if I would have rated them higher.
Mm-hmm. All right, Greg, some last words from you.
Yeah, my thought is this. I saw a research recently, and it says that the main source of information of voters came from television advertising, TV news, and third debates. I think we should have more of that, but I think networks like ABS should put it on prime time.
All right. Well, that's a challenge to us. And I hope our bosses are watching. We thank you so much for your time, Greg Garcia and Dr. Edna Co.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
Good night.
Good night.
Interesting. Very interesting. Just very briefly.
We have
two
no
things
more
that
time.
They said.
Okay.
Charm and sincerity. If you exude that, then you win.
You know, it reminds you of the Kennedy-Nixon debate.
That's right.
Yeah.
People listening on the radio thought Nixon won, but when the people watching on TV thought Kennedy won.
So does it mean forms Trump's substance?
I guess so, to some extent.